Could a tax and regulate system solve Vermont's marijuana woes? Some say one bill could be a good start.
What we're hoping is that this bill will create economic opportunities in the most underserved communities in Vermont so that people can enter a regulated cannabis industry.
The bill would create a control board that would issue licenses to sell cannabis. It also calls for a 10% tax on marijuana sales and for the Agency of Agriculture to test plants for pesticides, mold, or other things that could hurt consumers. But some told the Senate Judiciary Committee they're worried that the bill doesn't include highway safety testing or funding for drug prevention programs in schools, outreach which would cost between $6 and $8 million.
And we believe it would be not only unacceptable but unconscionable to have legislation that would create this kind of potential marketplace that would not at least make an effort explicitly to have a revenue stream going towards education and prevention and research.
Committee Chair Senator Dick Sears says he cares about safety, but he also cares about illegal marijuana sales. He believes issues like education and highway impairment testing should be in separate legislation so they can move forward regardless of what happens to the tax and regulate bill.
We're sitting here acting like there's nothing going on, and once we tax and regulate, everything will happen. Well, that's not the case, obviously.
Following a second day of testimony, the Senate's Finance Committee will start looking at the bill next week. In Montpelier, Renee Wunderlich, NBC5 News.